Hello everyone. In previous videos we discussed the two units of our syllabus. First was square and square root. Second one cube and cube root. I hope the videos were useful. And in the same regard, let us start the third unit that we have to learn, that is direct and inverse variation. And within this chapter we will learn the different terms, and I hope you will be able to solve the problems based on variation. Let us start the first term, that is variation. Variation from varies. Variation means changes in some quantity, that is age, weight, cost and etc. That means in these quantities, if there is some changing, then we say that they came under variation. And this is of two types of variation. Direct variation, first one is direct variation, and another is inverse variation. We shall move with direct variation. So what are direct variation? Two quantities like age, weight, cost, they are called quantities. The two quantities are said to be in direct variation if increase in one quantity results an increase in another quantity. For example, suppose cost of one book is 30. The cost of one book is 30. Now, if you will buy more books, then you have to pay more. That is, the more books you will buy, more it would cost. Therefore, here is two quantities. First one is the number of books, and second quantity is their cost. So these two quantities, number of books and cost, are related in some manner. That means number of books will increase, their cost will also increase. That means these two quantities, we can say that they are related by direct variation. And more examples you can choose from your surroundings. Like if you are riding a bike, then the more time you will travel, then more distance you will cover. Okay, we prepared a table for the number of books and its cost. We have given the cost of one book is 30. So you can easily find the cost of two books 60, three books 90, four books 120, five books 150. And from this table, what do we observe? We observe that the ratio of two quantities, that means number of books divided by their cost. Let us check what similarities between them. So we divided number of books by their cost. So first one, 1 by 30. Okay. Now second one is 2 by 60. On simplifying this, we get again 1 by 30. Now 3 by 90, again we get 1 by 30. 4 by 120 equal to 1 by 30. 5 by 150 is equal to 1 by 30. So what do we actually observe? We observe that the ratio of number of books and cost, these two quantities, the ratio is constant, ratio is same, that is 1 divided by 30. The ratio of two quantities is constant value, that is 1 by 30, and this constant value, that is the ratio of two quantities, is called constant of variation. Constant of variation. In the same manner, here is x and is y are two quantities. We can say that if x and y are two quantities such that they are in direct variation, then their ratio is constant. That we observed here, the ratio of the two quantities in every term, in every box, are constant. That is, x divided by y is a constant value, and we represent it by k, which is called constant of variation. Now, we suppose to form a formula, general formula. If two quantities x and y are in direct variation, and suppose the first value for x1, when x equal to x1, then y equal to y1, and when x equal to x2, then y equal to y2. Since they are in direct variation, therefore the ratio of two quantities will be same in both the respect. So therefore x1 by y1 equal to x2 by y2, that is k, a constant value, constant of variation. So we arrived a formula. If x and y are in direct variation, then x1 by y1 equal to x2 by y2, and use this formula. You observe there are four quantities, x1, x2, y1, y2, and suppose we are given three values, then you can easily find the fourth value by solving it. On the above basis, on the above discussion, let us take some examples, which type of questions you may arrive. So for example, the first question is, if x and y are two quantities which are in direct variation, then find the missing term. You can easily see these two tables are similar. So x and y are in direct variation. We are given the x1, y1, and x2. You have to find this missing value. We have to find, and third value is also given. Now we will use the formula here. First of all, you have to observe, you have to keep in mind, if they are in direct variation. Since x and y are in direct variation, therefore by using this formula, we have x1 by y1 equal to x2 by y2. Putting these values, x1 equal to 3, y1 equal to 15, and y2 equal to 35. And by cross multiplication, cross multiply, 15 into x2 equal to 3 multiply 35, and x2 equal to 335 divided by 15. On solving it, we get 7. Therefore, the missing term x2 is equal to 7. In this way, you can find the missing terms. If there are more missing terms, then you one by one you can find if any one value are given, you can find the other one. Let us take one more example, another time question. If x equal to 1.2 and y equal to 3.6 are in direct variation, then find the constant of variation. That is, we have to find the value of k. And we know that if x, y are in direct variation, then the ratio are constant. Then ratio means x divided by y is equal to a constant value k. On putting the value of x and y, we get k equal to 1 by 3. I hope this topic is somewhat clear for you, and later on in the next video we will discuss more examples, more questions, so that it would become more clear.